Live Time.
From politics to what's good in the hood, you're now tuned in to Danilo Ignacio's Live Time.
Affordable housing has become a buzzword to be used in speeches. Gotta ask.
I hope you're enjoying the conversation that we have, and I want you young black men to really watch what we're doing. You have two strong urban people that are sitting in front of you with hopes, dreams, and power for the future. And we want you to be a part of what we're doing. That's why this is also going to be on YouTube and MySpace and everything else in between. We want, let's get this man into office so we can have change. Just like Obama said, there's been a lot of the same looking people right in a lot of these offices. For the first time, we can bring young brothers in that can really take forth on the change because we come from that place. I know what it is not to have a plate of food because I need that money to go to work anymore.
Yeah, definitely.
And that's part of what I also like, where I actually met him at, which was Senator Hutley's office. Great lady, and again, tune in to Channel Live and everything that we do, because she'll be a part of the campaign. She was pushing for him to do this way back then.
Yeah, right.
So how is she doing?
She's doing well. Right now, she has a campaign of her own. The former council member, Alan Jennings, is attempting to mount a campaign against her.
Oh, okay.
Right, but we're confident that all the work that we've done over that first year and 8 months will speak for itself. And the people know.
Yeah.
The people know who works for them. And that's just another instance of it's time for something different.
That's right.
You know, her predecessor was there for 18 years. Mm-hmm. And no one believed that it could be done to take her out,
right,
out of office.
Right.
We mounted a campaign based on the community and the needs of the community and the services that the community was not getting.
Mm-hmm.
And the community stood up. They were shocked. We went against the county Democratic machine. We went against many unions. Now she is stationed at Shirley Hutton's.
Right.
And in that month, well, in that year and 8 months, we were the first ones in the nation to do a predatory lending and foreclosures.
Mm-hmm.
We were the first ones to do a joint session of the community boards.
Mm-hmm.
We believe that every community board has the same issues.
Exactly.
Southeast Queens as a whole has an infrastructure issue where every time it rains, people are praying that it's flooding.
Right.
So whether you're Haitian, whether you're Trinidadian, whether you're white, whether you're Asian, whether you're Latino, it doesn't matter because when it rains, you pray that hope that your home is not flooded.
That's
out.
Right.
So that we need to now stop being bound by a common lack, but look for the common good.
Mm-hmm.
Along with that, we were the ones who actually solidified the deal for the school construction authority at PS 48.
Okay.
So we're getting a new school built.
Cool.
Did that within a year and 8 months.
Yeah.
Wasn't a new school built anywhere in South Jamaica in the last 35 years.
And you know, that's funny because when, even like what you were talking about before, how come someone like Meeks,
mm-hmm,
can't apply something as easy as what you guys did within just the first run? You know what I mean?
It's hard to apply something when you're out of touch.
Mm-hmm, right.
And I'm not here to run on an Obama platform. I'm here to actually say that I believe this gentleman is out of touch with the community.
Exactly.
Sometimes you grow and you grow out of something.
Right.
And I don't want to say that he needs to be pushed out, but sometimes you have to be moved to be placed.
That's right.
And I think that at this point in time, the community is inviting him to leave. I would never have stepped out to do something with this type of tremendous task. To do this type of tremendous task,
mm-hmm,
without a lot of people coming to me, because I was slated to run for city council in 2009.
Right, right.
So this is something that was pushed, and it was the time schedule was accelerated.
It's
time for change. Nowhere else has there been a grassroots operation that was up and running in 2 weeks,
right,
where you gathered over 6,000 signatures.
Mm.
We haven't had elected officials out here not just gather, but we turned in 4,800 and some odd signatures. Elected officials out here with paid operations couldn't do it. So
right,
the community is speaking, and of course the status quo is believing that this is not something that can be done because it uproots what they're doing.
Right.
But the community knows it can be done and wants it to be done.
That's
we will have change on September 9th.
That's what I'm waiting on. That's what I'm praying for.
Yeah, no,
you
we
can
will,
do it.
Oh, we can do it.
And
what can we,
our average everyday brothers and sisters, do to help you right now?
Spread the word, breast to breast. When you're at someone's house and you're in a barbecue or you're just there eating dinner, bring up the election, bring up the campaign.
Right.
Speak about both candidates and our platforms.
Right.
Speak about the fact that I've done affordable housing and I want to work with affordable housing.
That's right.
Speak about the fact that I've designed affordable housing right now for two unions that we're trying to get in.
Mm-hmm.
Speak about the fact that there's not too many people that are going to have anything bad to say about me because
right,
I'm a worker.
Right.
Actually, to prove my commitment to the community, I'm getting ready to walk to Washington, D.C.
Wow. I'm with you. Let me know when we want to do it. We'll film it.
I think we're going to do it the third week in August.
Okay.
I'm going to walk 241 miles to Washington, D.C.
Let's do it.
Because I understand that the economic situation that our community is in stops us from willingly just giving money out to anyone. So instead of me just going and asking for campaign pledges, I want to make sure that what they're going into and what they're buying into, they believe that it's going to work for them.
That's right.
What we're doing now is currently getting petitions. And the petitions are designed to take every issue that everyone who wants to sign one of these petitions has. We just started yesterday. I think we have over 200 signatures.
Cool.
We did an hour and a half yesterday.
That's great.
The issues are issues of foreclosure, mm-hmm. education, infrastructure, jobs, the economy. It's a myriad of issues.
So you're just running on the people's platform.
The people, and it's for the people.
Because that's for the people.
That's how those we're
listening. Because when you listen to a lot of these people and what they say, why they're coming to do this, it's never for the people.
Right.
It's for the advancement of the person.
Right.
You know
see,
what I mean?
The key that you just spoke was when you listen.
Right.
And a lot of times, they're not listening or hearing. Mm. They're smiling and waving.
That's right.
You know, and these are some of the issues that we have. Hey, how are you? My name is Ruben Wills, and I am running for the United States Congress, 6th Congressional District, Queens. If you are, like most people, tired of the situations or conditions of our communities, come and get a part of this campaign, which is a campaign for change, a campaign to restore the hope of our people and the expectations of our community. You can get in touch with us by dialing 516-860-4929, or you can go onto the MySpace/RubenWills, or visit us on our Facebook. Our email address is people4RubenWills@gmail.com. Hope to see, hear, and get in touch with you soon.